I mean, this was just ridiculous. Last two runs. Just ridiculous. That I need to like play 2 seconds and then check to everyone. Like I said, this is not remembered from being overtly good at combat mechanics. Just against missile attacks. That's going after Morrigan. And she wasted one spell. Okay, and you decided to go after a crater shade. Nice. How nice of you. Okay, randomly this can actually do some good calls. Okay, Crater Shade came in. Say hello. He could taunt. Apparently shield bash does make some damage. Nice to know. And what are you casting for? Okay, let's take one at the time. Okay, try to run there if you wouldn't like catch the big bad flame blast. Right, we have Lyrium potion. That might help. Yes, that helps a lot, actually. Using drugs to win, or something. One down. Okay, don't you dare.
You cannot win.
this. The price is paid. Okay, that's not pleasant lady. Flippity hex. Scream, don't you scream for me. Okay, this was close range. Resisted. Okay, this works as well. No. Ouch. Yes, she's resisting. Okay, that works. Drain life. Okay, horror, it doesn't work on demons. Well, that's kind of logical if you think about it. Well, that works. And Morrigan for the win. Ha. Huh. Damn.
I shall do it.
Okay. Giving us our reward or something.
Stronger, at least.
So it's
I said I'd submit
Swiss cheese.
And so I shall. Can I be left to experiment in peace?
Kill him for your crimes. Death is only verdict. Well, in fact, he did only act on the desperation and orders. You just must atone research ways to help partners ethically. Your punishment is to live with what you have done. Yeah, that's what he's going to do. Okay, we can cast him out. Okay, you do research for the wardens, but this time ethically.
With what time I have left, I will do this. It may take months or years for my research to reach fruition. When it does, I will send for you. Thank you for this, Warden.
You've done it, Warden. Soldier's Peak is safe again.
Yay.
That old geezer Avernus deserves the gallows, if you ask me, but people will do queer things to survive. But if he does the proper research, without the sacrifices and blood magic and all, maybe he'll turn up something good, but there was no proof to redeem my family.
Well,
I suppose they were at that. For so long, I was focused on the past. on answers. But I think I would have been better off had I stayed at home. Enough of that, though. I find myself at a loss. You've got a whole fortress now. I suppose I should start plying my trade again. It is. In time, it might liven up, though. You're gathering an army, after all. A fortress may do some good with that.
That could work.
You know I'm no good in a fight, but I'm a fair trader if I do say so myself. My cousins have been looking for a safe place to store trade goods, and the peak will do nicely. Whatever the Drydens have to offer are yours, for a sizable discount.
Looks like we're done here.
A demonic invasion thwarted, a warden base safely rescued. We do good work.
Oh, there's a black stain. So there's several places we need to visit to gather support. And I'm trying to figure out what would be the best order of the missions. I have been rooting for Redcliff because that would be like most logical. And they're born to be a demons in Mad Mage's Tower, so that's why we are not going there. Okay. Random encounter.
Stranger, the doors are marked closed off. Old Tegrin can give you a discount.
Nice.
Fine weapon and arms, dwarven made.
So, steel dagger.
Look. Can we talk for a moment? I need to tell you something. I should probably have told you earlier. Well, let's see. How do I tell you this? We're almost at Redcliff. Did I say how I know Arl Eamon?
No.
I'm a bastard. My mother was a serving girl at Redcliff Castle, and she died when I was born. Arl Eamon took me in and raised me before I was sent to the Chantry.
Oh, no, it's nice of him.
Because my father was King Marek.
Uh-huh.
Which made Kaelin my half-brother, I suppose.
Okay. What a bomb.
Ha! Yes, I guess it does at that. I should use that line more often. I would have told you, but it never really meant anything to me. I was inconvenient, a possible threat to Kaelin's rule, and so they kept me secret. I'd never talked about it to anyone. Everyone who knew either resented me for it or they coddled me. Even Duncan kept me out of the fighting because of it. I didn't want you to know as long as possible. I'm sorry.
You still should have told me. Does Logan know?
Why wouldn't
good,
he?
Good question.
He was King Marek's best friend. I don't know if that means anything, though. I certainly never considered the idea that it might ever be important.
Well, now it is.
Arl Eamon eventually married a young woman from Orlais. Despite all the problems it caused with the king so soon after the war. He loved her a great deal.
Ah.
Anyway, the new Arlesser resented the rumors which pegged me as the Arl's bastard. They weren't true, but of course they existed. The Arl didn't care, but she did. So off I was packed to the nearest monastery at age 10. Just as well. The Arlesser made sure the castle wasn't a home to me by that point. She despised me. She may have, but I think it's more likely that she feared the rumors might be true. I can't blame her for that. I remember I had an amulet with Andraste's holy symbol on it. The only thing I had of my mother's. I was so furious at being sent away, I tore it off and threw it at the wall. And it shattered. Stupid, stupid thing to do. The Arl came by the monastery a few times to see how I was, but I was stubborn. I hated it there and blamed him for everything. And eventually, he just stopped coming. Let's hope not. I'm the son of a commoner and a Grey Warden to boot. It was made very clear to me early on that there was no room for me raising any rebellions or such nonsense. And that's fine by me. No, if there's an heir to be found, it's Arl Eamon himself. He's not of royal blood, but he is Caelan's uncle, and more importantly, very popular with the people. Though, if he's really as sick as we've heard...
No, yes, how sick he really is.
I really don't. So there you have it. Now can we move on? And I'll just pretend you still think I'm some nobody who was too lucky to die with the rest of the Grey Wardens.
You command, my prince.
Oh, lovely. I'm going to regret this.
Oh, definitely. Right. Areal unlocked. Can we return to camp? Yes, we can. Can we? Now we can. Because we need to rest and nurse our wound.
You look like a woman.
What? I am.
You are a Grey Warden, so it follows that you can't be a woman.
What?
Women are priests, artisans, shopkeepers, or farmers. They don't fight.
No, they do. That's not a very comprehensive list.
The laborers, soldiers, and Ashkari are men. There is nothing else left.
What if they don't want to be any of those things?
What does that have to do with anything? No one gets to choose who they are.
Didn't you choose to be a soldier?
Of course not. It is who I am. That's not up to me. A person is born, Gunari or human or elven or dwarf. He doesn't choose that. The size of his hands, whether he is clever or foolish, the land he comes from, the color of his hair, these are beyond his control. We do not choose. We simply are.
But a person can choose what to do.
Can they? We'll see.
Oh, okay.
What do you need?
I think we had some gifts here. Do I just click the item or... No, it's grayed out.
What do you wish of me? If you must. What do you wish of me? We are in camp, so 'tis as good a time as any. I am here because Flemeth commanded me to aid you. Why? Do you wish me to leave? I can do so if you prefer. Then I assume our discussion ends here.
Did you always live in an alienage? Was it very terrible?
Yes.
That is good to hear. I have never been to the Denerim alienage, but I hear that life is hard and there is so much squalor. In Orle, most Alvin servants live in the homes of their masters, often in great wealth and luxury. I've known Elven servants with servants of their own. A well-trained Elven servant is highly valued in Orle. They are nimble and dexterous, and many people find them pleasing to look at.
Like a prize-winning animal.
No, I did not mean it that way. Oh, my words were clumsily chosen. I did not mean to offend. I am sorry. Thank you. You have given me a lot to think about.
Sten can stay behind if he thinks that women can't be fighters.
I thought I saw travelers coming down the road, though I scarcely believed it. Have you come to help us?
What do you mean?
So you don't know? Has nobody out there heard?
No, what? I heard Arl Eamon is sick.
He could be dead for all we know. Nobody's heard from the castle in days.
Okay.
We're under attack. Monsters come out of the castle every night and attack us until dawn. Everyone's been fighting and dying.
Apparently everyone seems to agree that a blight is the perfect time to start killing each other. Marvelous, really.
Map.
We've no army to defend us. No Arl and no king to send us help. So many are dead. And those left are terrified they're next.
Hold on, what is this evil that's attacking you?
I don't rightly know. I'm sorry, nobody does. I should take you to Ban Tegan. He's all that's holding us together. He'll want to see you.
Ban Tegan, Arleman's brother. He's here.
Yes. It's not far, if you'll come with me.
Apparently things are going wrong.
It's Thomas, yes? And who are these people with you? They're obviously not simple travelers.
No, my lord. They just arrived, and I thought you would want to see them.
Well done, Thomas. Greetings, friends. My name is Tegan, Ban of Rainosphere, brother to the Arl.
I remember you, Ban Tegan, though the last time we met, I was a lot younger and covered in mud.
Covered in mud? Alistair? It is you, isn't it? You're alive! This is wonderful news!
Still alive, yes. Though not for long, if Tern Loghain has anything to say about it.
Indeed. Loghain would have us believe all Grey Wardens died along with my nephew, amongst other things. What, that he pulled his men in order to save them? That Caelan risked everything in the name of glory? Hardly. Loghain calls the Grey Wardens traitors, murderers of the king. I don't believe it. It is an act of a desperate man. So you are a Grey Warden as well. A pleasure to meet you. I wish it were under better circumstances. You're here to see my brother. Unfortunately, that might be a problem. Eamon is gravely ill. No one has heard from the castle in days. No guards patrol the walls, and no one has responded to my shouts. The attack started a few nights ago. Evil things surged from the castle. We drove them back, but many perished during the assault. Some call them the walking dead, decomposing corpses, returning to life with a hunger for human flesh. They hit again the next night. Each night they come with greater numbers. With Caelan dead and Loghain starting a war over the throne, no one responds to my urgent calls for help. I have a feeling tonight's assault will be the worst yet. Alistair, I hate to ask, but I desperately need the help of you and your friends.
It isn't just up to me. Though the Grey Wardens don't stand much chance against Loghain without Arleman.
How pointless to help these villagers fight an impossible battle. One would think we had enough to contend with elsewhere.
Thank you. Thank you. This means more to me than you can guess. Thomas, please tell Murdoch what transpired. Then return to your post.
Yes, my lord.
Now then, there is much to do before night falls. I put two men in charge of the defense outside. Murdoch, the village mayor, is outside the chantry. Sir Perth, one of Eamon's knights, is just up the cliff at the windmill, watching the castle. You may discuss with them the preparations for the coming battle. Of course. I have those few who returned from their quest. You know of this, yes? Yes, I question Isolde's decision to send so many knights in search of this relic. But I am a practical man, whereas she is a woman of great faith. Sir Perth was one of the knights sent on this quest. Perhaps you should speak to him if you wish to learn more. Hopefully we can find the source and stop it before it causes any more damage. With luck, we'll also find Eamon and be able to help him. I do not know. They seem to be walking corpses, men with rotting flesh that continue to attack even with the gravest injuries.
Undead? Spirits possessing the dead. There could be several causes behind such a thing, none of them pleasant.
Very well. Luck be with you, my friend.
All right.
Surprise attack before the sun goes down. So you're the Grey Warden, are you? I didn't think they made women Grey Wardens.
Well, they do.
What do you say? A damn Qunari could walk up and say he was a Grey Warden. I wouldn't know the difference. We aren't going to turn aside anyone who wants to help, though. Don't take me for being an ingrate or nothing.
Well, we do want to help however we can. You can trust us.
Name's Murdoch, mayor of what's left of the village, providing we aren't all killed and hauled off to the castle tonight.
Have faith, good man.
I hope you're right. I've been trying to hold us together, but it isn't easy. Anyhow, you're here, and they tell me you're in charge. Morale's about what you'd expect. These men aren't soldiers. They're villagers defending their homes, and they're frightened. It would help if we had decent equipment. There weren't enough swords in Owen's shop, and the men's armor is nearly falling off. I don't think we're in any shape to fight. We'll do our best, of course, but, well, I have my doubts. I just hope I'm alive tomorrow morning. Oh? Ask away. If you want weapons and such, you'd go to the blacksmith, but there isn't much left there. All right. Oh? Ask away. Don't rightly know. We heard the Arl was sick and getting
Cyrus. Sick.
After a while, we heard nothing at all. A few folks went up to the castle to see what was going on. They couldn't get in. Nobody was there. Not a soul. And then those horrid creatures attacked the village. They were everywhere. People dying. It was awful. Good thing Bantigan was here. No. I know the Arlesa sent the knights out for a cure.
Had to be serious illness.
Right. Let's hope we see morning.
Yeah, so.
Go away. Curse you. Leave me in peace. You've already taken everything out of my stores. There's nothing left. Alright, just don't destroy anything, damn you.
Make his breath. What is that smell? It's like someone set a brewery on fire.
Somebody's been drinking.
So, I open the door. I've got nothing of value for you. The militia's taken whatever I had. So if you're here to beat on a sad old man, then all I ask is you get on with it. I don't have much to live for as it is. Is that so? Then talk then. My girl, Valena, is one of the Alessa's maids, and she's up there in the castle, but the mayor won't send anyone for her. She's been my life since my wife passed on 2 years ago. Now she's dead, or soon to be. I don't care what happens to me or the village or anyone.
I will rescue your daughter.
To think maybe someone like you. Go in and find her. Provided any of us live through the night. It would be better than going to my grave wondering. Not good enough. Murdoch said the same damn thing, and I didn't believe him either.
You were asking a great deal, you wretched little man.
I want a promise. Promise me that you'll look for her. That you'll bring her back to me if you can. I'll accept that. It's something to hope for, at least.
Oh, lovely. Shall we next begin rescuing kittens from trees?
And I suppose there's no point in me sitting around, is there? Time to relight the forge and get the smithy going, eh? Murdoch will be pleased.
Yeah, you do that.
If you need anything done, well, just let me know. I've got a lot to do now, so you'll have to excuse me. I must admit, it feels good to be up and doing something finally. There's no way I'm sobering up before morning, however. Right. I haven't got much, obviously, but I'll do whatever I can for you.
So, okay, he has a steel greatsword. daggers were pretty okay in this game. They had a like critical chance. So why not? I don't have much of anything. What? Okay, that's an iron dagger.
Why do you always go on about how stupid I am? I'm not stupid, am I?
If you need to ask the question.
Because it hurts my manly feelings, you know. Or one of them.
Then I'll be sure to write you an apology once all of this is over.
I was educated by the Chantry. I studied history. They don't make stupid Templars.
Then I must have been mistaken. I'm very impressed.
No, you're not. You're not even listening to me.
My, you are smarter than you look after all. Your Chantry must have been very proud.
This isn't your home. This is my home. My home, you hear me? No, I'm not going back there. I won't. What? You wouldn't. Ah, what are you doing? All right, I'll come out.
Young boy.
Don't hurt me. I'll go back to the Chantry if you want. I didn't mean any harm. Yes. It was my mother's house. She's dead now. And Caitlin said we have to move away if we survive. It's Bevan. My sister is Caitlin. She's probably at the Chantry looking for me. No, I just didn't want to be in the Chantry anymore. Everyone's scared. And I want to be brave.
So you hide in the cupboard. Okay. Makes perfect sense.
I wasn't always in here. I hid when I heard you coming. I was... Well, I shouldn't tell you. It's a secret.
Why?
You could. Alright, I guess. I just... Father said I could have his sword when I grew up. It was Grandfather's. And Grandfather was a great dragon slayer.
Uh-huh.
I thought... If I was brave like Grandfather, I could use his sword and kill the bad people who took Mother.
Where is this sword now?
In Mother's room. Father gave me a key, but I'm not supposed to give it to anyone.
I could use that sword to help the village.
I can't give it to you. It was Father's. Caitlin would be so mad if I did. Could? Maybe you could give my sister money? She said if we had money, we'd be all right, even if Mother is dead. Oh, all right. Here's the key. I hope you use it to kill a lot of those bad people. I should go back to the Chantry. Good luck.
All right. Missing child. So... Probably here. Okay, that's a chest. Green blade! Hey, this is not bad at all. 19 strength. And Alistair had only, like, pretty normal. Longsword. This is not bad weapon at all. +6 against beasts. Apparently, dragons are beasts. So, makes perfect sense. Then we need to go and pay for it.
It is begun. Bevan said you were the one who found him.
I can't possibly repay you. Bevan told me about Grandfather's sword. So you have it, then? I suppose it won't go to waste, at least. I have no idea what it's worth, to be honest. And you found Bevan. I couldn't ask you for money.
It's a valuable sword here, 100 silver, take it.
Thank you! That's certainly a lot of coin. How can I ever repay you?
That was more problem than these words. Just say they save.
I just know it. Thank you again.
Okay.
Hello there, friend. Can't say we've ever met before. Stranger to the village, I take it. Haven't had many travelers lately. All this nonsense is bad for business. Bet you regret coming, yes? Oh, you know, evil creatures, impending doom, civil war, and the Earl's dead in the castle. Makes you thirsty, don't it? So, what'll it be? You are here to drink, I hope. Fine, make them quick. Why? When them creatures attack, I lock myself in the cellar, just batten the hatches and wait it out. What's the point in getting myself killed with all the rest of them? If that makes me a coward, then I'm a coward.
Intimidate.
But Van Tegen said we didn't have to. He said... Fine, I'll go. But all of this better be here when I get back. I don't want the place drunk out from under me. Blasted bloody...
That works.
I see you got that bastard Lloyd to join the militia. It's about time he did something to help out.
I guess this puts me in charge.
Yes.
Poor Lloyd will have an apoplexy just thinking about it, eh?
Fair enough. Let me see what Lloyd stored in the back. You can help yourself.
Help yourself.
Greetings, Grey Warden. I am as relieved as Ban Tegan is to see you here. I must admit, I do not know how to address an elf in your position. I do not wish to be rude.
Right. Call me Grey Warden, that's what I am.
Grey Warden it is then, and thank you kindly. I am Sir Perth, until recently in direct service of Arl Eamon of Redcliffe. For now my charge is defending the village from these evil assaults. Would that I had chosen not to seek out the Urn of Sacred Ashes. Perhaps I would have fended off whatever evil befell the castle, or perhaps I would be dead. Ah well, with a Grey Warden aiding our defense, perhaps all is not lost. We have sufficient armor and weapons, but my knights are too few to stand against the monsters without assistance. Perhaps you could approach Mother Hannah in the Chantry for some holy protection against these evil creatures. Otherwise, I do not know what else you could provide beyond your own talents. We're as prepared for the onslaught as we could possibly be, all things considered. That gladdens my heart to hear it. As you wish, Grey Warden, make a watch over you.
You are of elven blood and a stranger, yet you defend a home that is not your own. We are grateful for that.
Is there a reason I shouldn't help? I cannot stand by while monsters attack the helpless. True.
Many in these modern days would honestly say the same. You are a woman of worth, and the Maker will smile upon you. Allow me to introduce myself. I am revered Mother Hannah, head of this chantry, which for the moment is a place of refuge for these poor villagers.
How awful this must be for you all. Is this everyone who's left?
All those who cannot defend themselves, yes. They are terrified of tonight's attack, and I fear these walls will not keep them safe. What can I do to help with your task?
Sir Perth needs holy protection for the knights.
I have done all I can for them. I pray for them each night and seek the Maker's forgiveness for their sins before they face their deaths. What Sir Perth seeks is something that is not in my power to give.
Can't you just bless them?
I can pray with them and give them my blessing. But Sir Perth wants me to call upon the Maker to shield them from evil.
Well, can't you just tell him the Maker will watch over him? Morale is a powerful thing, you know.
You mean you want me to let them think the Maker protects them in a real sense? I will not lie to them like that.
Persuade. But if they think it helps them.
I suppose their belief in the Maker's power could inspire them, but it just seems like trickery.
Hard questions.
If it keeps them alive, I will do what I must. I have a number of silver-cast holy symbols. Tell Sapirth that he can have them, and that wearing them will confer the Maker's protection. Now please, let me tend to these poor folk. I must do what I can, and I suggest you do the same.
That's actually pretty good discussion, and I really like how the religion is actually portrayed in this game and this. What you can promise is to pray for something, not always get what you want, like a coin in a vending machine. That's praying doesn't work like that.
Have you spoken to the revered mother? Has she offered anything?
Okay, so we can actually now choose. Mother Hannah does not believe she can help you. Well, that's true. Mother Hannah has some holy amulets. Would these do?
Must we do this? The faith that will protect these men must come from their heart, surely.
Well, it will come.
The symbols worn by their priests, well, that would more than suffice.
I'm glad that I could help.
I will send some men to collect the amulets. Please give my regards to Mother Hannah for seeing some sense at last. No, nothing comes to mind. If you have not spoken to the Mayor, Murdoch, you should. His militia is far more in need of aid than we are. Ask me whatever you wish. When the Isle fell sick, we were at a loss. Nothing worked to cure him, and he just kept getting worse. Finally, our lesser Isolde came up with a plan. The Urn of Sacred Ashes is a legendary artifact said to hold great healing powers. If found, it might save him.
According to the legend, the followers of Andraste brought her ashes back to Ferelden to hide them from the Imperium.
We knights volunteered to seek it out. Few of us have returned. Many are still out there, unaware of what is happening here. The Earl once employed a scholar. Brother Genetivi.
Genetivi.
We have proof the urn was in Ferelden, or so I was told. We were never certain. He thirsted for water and then grew weaker and weaker. He brought in a mage, but even that did nothing. The Alessa believed he was cursed and that we needed the power of Andraste herself, or he would surely perish. Not at all. A great number of soldiers remained in Castle Redcliffe. I wonder if they perished there, or were transformed into these things. The thought chills my blood. Eventually, perhaps. The ones I have here were those near enough to recall within the last few days. I only returned myself because I was passing by Redcliffe and heard the news of strange attacks. As you wish. Although we are far better equipped than Murdoch and his villagers, we knights are too few. Things will be grim after sundown. Overall, I believe my knights are ready for the coming battle. Morale is high, thanks to you. Ask me whatever you wish. You know about as much as I do. I returned a day before the attacks began, having heard strange rumors about the abandoned castle. I was the only knight to survive the first attack. Since then, I found others returning from the Arlesa's quest. Until we get to the source of this evil, though, I do not think it will stop, and I don't believe we will be enough. As you say, we are prepared to meet the enemy here when they come. Maker, prepare us. We shall be victorious.
The men were short on decent armor and weapons for a while, but Owen, the blacksmith, has started repairing our equipment. Stubborn fool was refusing to talk to anyone only this morning. You didn't have anything to do with his change of heart, did you? Maybe we'll make it through this night after all. The damn fool is falling over a drunk and still manages to make smithying look easy. Good enough, I say. I'll inform Bantigan and the militia is ready to fight. We'll give those bastards a welcome they won't soon forget. I hope you're right. We may just be village folk, but we're going to fight like there's no tomorrow. Are you sure? There's still time left if you need to talk with Sir Perth or do anything else. Then good luck to you. You'll need it.